terrifying enemy surfaced, as such enemies often do, in the seemingly most innocent and unlikely of places.
saying, but has it ever occurred to you that maybe what the firm needs is to move in a new direction?
What Seymour's trying to say, Mr. Mushnick, is that we talked about it and we both agreed. Seymour, why don't you run in the back and bring out that strange plant you've been working on? Mr. Mushnick, some of those exotic plants that Seymour's been tinkering around with are really unusual. And we were both thinking that maybe some of those strange and interesting plants prominently displayed and advertised would attract business.
I'm afraid it's not feeling very well.
There! Now isn't that bizarre?
What kind of weirdo plant is that, Seymour?
I don't know. It looks like some kind of flytrap, but I haven't been able to identify it in any of the books, so I gave it my own name. I call it an Audrey 2.
Oh!
Strange and interesting plant like this here in the window, then maybe
something... Maybe what? Do you have any idea how ridiculous you sound? Just because you put a strange and interesting plant in the window, you must...
Excuse me! I couldn't help noticing that strange and interesting plant! What is it?
It's an Audrey too.
Have you ever seen anything like it?
No, no one has.
Where did you get it?
Well... Do you remember that total eclipse of the sun a couple of weeks ago? I was walking in the cell tower district that day. And I passed by this place where this old Chinese man, he sometimes sells me weird and exotic cuttings. Because he knows, you see, strange plants are my hobby.
Thank you.
grow and wilt. Spurt and flop. You sickly little plant, or are you just plain stubborn? What is it you want, huh? What is it you need? I've given you sunshine.
They do.
kissed. You know, I wanted to cheer him on. I tried to be on time, but...
And don't tell me. You got tired.
No, just handcuffed a little.
Girl, I don't know who this mess is you're hanging out with, but he is hazardous to your health.
Well, that's for sure, but I can't leave him.
Why not?
Because he'd get angry.
And if he does this to me when he likes me, imagine what he'd do if he ever got mad.
So, dump the trunk, get another guy, and let him protect you.
We got one all picked out.
An unbotanical genius.
She ain't talking about George Washington Carver either.
Ah!
Seymour.
Bingo.
No, and we're just friends. I could never be Seymour's girl. I've got a past.
And who amongst us has not?
I don't even deserve a sweet, considerate, suddenly successful guy like Seymour. This child suffers from low self-image.
You have a point. She had a point.
I know Seymour is the greatest. But I'm dating a semi-sadist. So I got a black eye and my arms in a cast. Still, that Seymour is a cutie. Well, if not, he's got inner beauty. And I dream of a place where we could be together.
It's just a little daydream of mine. A little development I dream of just off the interstate. And it's not fancy, like Levittown. It's just a little street and a little suburb far, far from urban Skid Row. It's the sweetest, greenest place where everybody has the same little door out front and the same little flagstone patio out back. Because they all look just alike. I dream about it all the time. It's just me and a tungsten. And a sweet little guy. Like Seymour. A matchbox of our own. A fence of real chain link.
It's right over there. too. You better come back tomorrow, man.
This shop is closed today.
Dude, we took his alibi! I'm not here to buy posies, girls. I'm here to pick up my date!
Your date? Mm-hmm. You ain't by any chance talking about a girl with a black eye.
And several other medical problems.
That's him! Please, I'm friendly. Truce. Hutch him. You want some nitrous oxide?
Why don't you get lost by Tavis Brains? The last thing Archie needs is more of your kind.
My kind is a very nice kind. I'm not a monster.
And what else would you call me?
I would call it an occupational hazard.
It
you see, ladies, my line of work requires a certain fascination with human pain and suffering. This stuff is great. Allow me to explain. When I was younger, just a bad little kid, my mama noticed funny things I did. Shooting puppies with a BB gun. I'd poison guppies, and when I was done, I'd find a pussycat scratching its head. That's when my mama said,
"What did she say?"
She said, "My boy, I think someday you'll find a way to make your natural tendencies pay." POP
go now.
It's okay.
right? You said you raised this thing, right?
Right.
Well, if I were you, I sure as hell couldn't keep it under a barrel down in a skid row dump like this. This avocado here could be your ticket to the stars. Hey, you could take this thing to any florist shop in town and name your price. Hell, somebody make you a goddamn partner to get their hands on this.
No, that's okay. I'm happy here.
Somebody talking to you?
No, excuse me.
Excuse me, what?
Excuse me, doctor.
That's better. I'm telling you, kid. This thing is a big green gold mine. Get your ass out of this dump and take the plant with you. What? Mushnick Skid Row florist? Oh, it's like a joke. You hear me talk?
Hey, yeah, 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 you, I hear you.
Should I be leaving now? Oh, sorry.
Sorry, what?
Sorry, doctor.
I'm sorry, doctor.
You got a train? Face up.
Well, my bike's outside. Double parked.
Think about what I said, scout.
I mean it. Think about it.
Yes, sure, sure. I'll think about it.
Think about it.
Good.
You do that.
Down to
And someday, when I own this whole shop, I'll remember I owe it to you.
Who cares if I've been a little on the anemic side lately? Yes, oh, I don't know, I've had a few dizzy spells, little lightheadedness. It's all been worth it, old pal. Oh, that's too weird. I'm a little hungry. I'm gonna run down to Schmendrick's and get a bite to eat, so I will see you in just... Oh! 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 Boy, here we go again. Look, I haven't got much more. All right, just give me a few more days to heal, will you? And then we'll start again with the left hand? I beg your pardon?
Justify.
say.
But it's true, isn't it?
No, no, no! I don't know anyone who deserves to get chopped up and then fed to a hungry plant.
Sure you do.
Stupid woman, Christ! Freaking scatterbrain!
I'm sorry, Doctor. I'm sorry, Doctor.
Get the hell in there and pick up the goddamn sweating engine, pal.
Right away.
Move it, you little slut! How do you like that stupid date for getting a freaking sweater? Christ, if your stupid head weren't screwed off!
Everyone has to put up with that pain for another day.
Now,
the girl.
mask off now. Okay, got one on the other side. No
problem. I got this all.
I could asphyxiate in here.
Seymour, give me a hand, will ya?
Yeah.
stick and sign. Please hold. It's just as the plan foretold. It's business like who'd have ever guessed. That was me. That was me. I'm channel brain.
So why am I feeling so
mean? I got 2 free tickets to the game. Once you get signed, get us ready.
They're okay.
Daddy?
Don't you Mr. Daddy me? Audrey, I wonder if you'd excuse Seymour and me for a little while. Perhaps you'd like to go visit your dentist friend.
Oh, that's not very funny, Daddy. Now he disappeared.
Oh, that's right, he did, didn't he? Forgive me, boy.
What's he talking about, Seymour? What's he doing?
Why don't you run along? Like, yes, Audrey, I'll catch up with you later. I'll call for you, if that's okay.
Investigation into the disappearance of this motorcycle dentist. And when they did, it seems they found a Mushnik Skid Row florist bag in his office.
What is that supposed to mean?
Exactly what I asked myself, Seymour. Then I began to think about certain things I've noticed around here lately. Things clean around here, isn't it? Especially when they only remove our garbage once a month.
What does that have to do with it? Where are you going?
You want something removed in a hurry? It's best not to dispose of it on Skid Row.
What are you talking about?
Yes! A dentist uniform! I saw it last week and didn't think twice. And the little red dot seemed innocent enough. Then I catch you kissing the dentist's girlfriend. And it begins to look like a motive. Don't you know the way you move in, right? I think it's a
good time.
I'm innocent. How do you explain this?
Picture of a baseball cap.
Your baseball cap? The police found it in Scrivello's office. Showed it to me and asked me if I could identify it.
Did you?
No. They don't suspect you at all, Seymour. They don't know about the dots, the uniform, the girlfriend.
I didn't do it!
Then come with me to the police and tell them that!
Just so
my conscience will rest easy. You know, I'm gonna tell them myself.
He's gonna turn you in.
You know where you come?
They're gonna put you in jail.
Okay.
So is he.
Lock up.
Thank you.
on. We've been trying to reach you, baby. Have your phones been busy? Did you get my telegram?
I don't think so.
I'm gonna think I came down in person. I'm pleased to meet you, kid. Skip? Snap! William Morris Agency! Put up the game, I'll be sent you. It's nice to meet me. The pleasure is yours now. Let my firm represent you. We want to book you on lecturing tours.
Don't you think I know it needs food? Don't you think I know it'll die if I don't feed it soon?
ask you something? Suppose, just for a minute, that there'd never even been an Audrey to me. That I was just a nothing. Again. A nobody. Would you still like me?
I'd still love you. Seymour.
Then it's settled.
Settled.
And bullets and rat poison and a machete tomorrow morning at the Light magazine takes a picture, you know, who bites the dust. Right, we'll snap the photo, we'll be famous. I'll take that TV job and then we will go live a nice, quiet, normal life. No more nightmares, no more squalling for blood.
What blood? What blood? Seymour, I don't get it. Bullets, knives, rat poison. You're scaring me.
There's nothing to be scared of, Audrey. We will go away from here. I will take you to that little development you always dreamed of. And once we are there, we are going to live happily ever after, I promise. A nice little house, a nice little car, and no pets. No pets at all.
You're talking so peculiar, Seymour.
I'll explain everything tomorrow. Just go home now, Audrey, please.
I can't leave you in this condition.
Don't worry about me.
Shut up!
terrible things, Audrey, but not to you. Never, never to you.
But I want you to, Seymour.
What?
When I die, which should be very shortly, give me to the plants so that I can live
and bring you all the wonderful things you deserve. I don't know what you say.
But I do. It's the one gift I can give you. And if I'm in the plants, then I'm part of the plants. And so, in a way, we'll always be together.
Right now. Imagine board, Audrey twos, everywhere. Why, with the right advertising, this could be bigger than hula hoops.
Bigger than hula hoops.
Because
every household in America, thousands of you eat it. That's what you had in mind all along, isn't it?
No shit, Sherlock!
I'm not talking about 100 million! We're talking about world conquest!
A power that
you're a monster and so am I!
Feed me!
You ain't the only thing I ever loved!
Too bad!
Here, rat boy! Eat that! Eat it! Eat it!
Crowboy. Mr. Crowboy. Okay, girls. All you have to do is snip some of the smaller leaves and replant them in these pots. There's a truck waiting outside.